Let me talk to you. Sitting here on my couch right now, just got home from work, taking off my boots. Impact is tonight, and I can't help but wonder what GWN throwback match they will have for us tonight. Now, as much as I appreciate the marketing behind it, you know, if you remember the other company releasing their app several years ago, and it felt like the entire episodes were about the app, and they wouldn't stop talking about it, and they were shoving it down people's throats, and a lot of people actually weren't buying it right away, or downloading it, whatever you want to call it, signing up right away, because of really obnoxious marketing that they were doing. So I appreciate the idea of doing a throwback match. I think we don't need to see the matches in their entirety. That's a lot of the reason I didn't enjoy a lot of the one-night onlys in the past, because, you know, they would play old matches, and just I just didn't really have interest in watching the entire thing a lot of the time. So while I think it's a good way of plugging the app and reminding people what the history is, it can also be really, really depressing. You look at the crowd. Gosh, here's, for instance, when Joseph Park took on that mid-carder Bully Ray. There was, I forgot what pay-per-view that was. There was 3,000 people there that night. I believe it was in Arizona. I think that was the location. And, you know, some of these throwback matches have a good 1,000 people in the crowd. It's a little depressing. It's back when, you know, they could turn on the lights all the way, and there's a lot of passion behind the commentary. And of course, it was an edgier product as well. So while I appreciate it, it's also really hard to watch. Because then you go to the modern day Impact Zone, and we can talk about the Impact Zone all day. And as I've maintained many times that I do, as someone who's been there, do strongly feel it is mostly Impact fans in there. And I'm going to tell you why. For those of you who haven't been to the Impact Zone, and there's going to be podcasters and everything that be, oh, you know, it's all, you know, park goers. They just go out and grab them, and they come in because it's hot and they take a break. It's not even like that. The Impact Zone is like nowhere near the attractions. I mean, nowhere near. There's a strip that has a bunch of, I don't know if you want to call it a strip, but a bunch of restaurants. And you don't have to have tickets to go inside the park to sit there. And even that is still not that close to the Impact Zone. Like, you come in, you go through the metal detectors, and then you kind of walk past the little eating area. And then there's like a big lake where they'll do like water shows and everything. And you got to walk all the way around that. And on the other side of that is the where the Blue Man Group perform and the Impact Zone. So the actual locations, and actually the Impact Zone is actually the closest part of the park that it's actually next to is the exit. You know what I mean? So yes, there are some people inside the park who are, you know, promoting the show, and it's a, hey, live wrestling event, you know, da da da. Yes, there is that, but it's not the Impact Zone is not like smack dab in the park. It's not next to the rides. It's not, you know. So anyway, with all that being said, it's still very depressing to watch. I mean, there's certain episodes where the crowd does a really good job, and then there's episodes where they're leaning on the rails and they're on their phones, and then lately we've been getting the people in the front who have their back towards the camera. And if you read any reviews, 411 Mania, another really good one is Aces and S. I don't even know how you pronounce it. But they do a really good write-up as well. And it's any site you read talks about the fans with their backs towards the camera and everything. So it's really depressing to watch. I wonder what you guys think about it. Most people I talk to kind of feel the same way. Like, it's a really good idea to show that stuff. But at the same time, it's like, God, man, why can't we get back to that? And, you know, so it's not just the crowd. It's the commentary too. And as much as we want to take jabs at the current commentary, I mean, if the crowd is not into it, it's a little difficult for the commentary team to do so, the broadcast team. But with that being said, they're doing the broadcast team is doing their commentary as an overdub, so they're not even in the arena, so it's going to be very difficult to really get excited and to sound excited. So that's something they got to fix. But with all that being said, it's very difficult to watch these throwback matches, and the matches are really good. They're excellent. when they're showing an Austin Aries beat Bobby Roode for the title, you know, I mean, how engaged the freaking people were into it. And then you think about, you know, Johnny Impact versus Alberto El Patron, and the people aren't engaged in that. You know what I'm saying? So great idea, but I think it's just time to start focusing on what else the GWN can bring instead of relying on the library so much. You know, they're doing really good things with Twitch, and now it's time. What are they going to do with GWN? It's time for them to step it up, and let's get some programming that makes us want to have the app. And that was where the WWE app failed in the beginning, is that they didn't focus on the content. They focused on a really ridiculous $9.99 marketing scheme that was actually more annoying than anything. And I think it's just time. It's just time for us. So what are you guys going to do? Are we going to get some content, really exclusive content, like behind the scenes stuff? Are we going to get, when they did the Global Forge thing, like they could have put together like a little reality show, so to speak, for Global Forge. So there was different things that they could have done, and they can still do, but it's really time to step it up and stop focusing on that. When they do the Pluto, you know, moment, it's always something quick. And I wish the GWN one was a little more like that instead of us watching the whole thing. That's all I've got for you guys. Please hit the subscribe button if you're a first timer. We'll talk to you soon. Peace.